Do you accept the charges? This is Lockup Unlocked Quarantine Calls Edition, the only show where you get behind the scenes exclusives and interviews from your favorite cast members of WeTV's Love After Lockup. Hey guys, happy quarantining. I hope all is well with you. Hope you're staying positive and productive. I'm trying to. Today we've got Brittany and Marcelino.
I'm still very sexually attracted to Amanda.
I think you need to know if you really want to marry this guy.
Will you marry me?
Yes! Yes!
I'm pregnant.
You pregnant?
Brittany is opening up to us about her past in a way that she's never done before. And of course, Marcelino is still being that supportive husband. You guys are one of our favorite couples on the show, and we're dying to know, what have you been up to?
Life has been good since the last time you've seen us. We undertook some minor construction at the house, so
yes.
Been real busy.
And I just published my first book, and I'm so excited about that. It's called One Woman's Journey, Surviving the Streets, and it is available on Amazon. And I just cannot tell you guys like how accomplished I feel just getting it done, really.
Shameless plug, shameless plug, shameless plug. In the background.
Shameless plug alert. Hey, there's nothing wrong with it. You didn't work all these blood, sweat, and tears into this book for no one to read it. Tell us about it. It's okay. I know that you had to go into a dark part of your brain that you probably tried to forget about. So I appreciate you opening up about this. How was it writing a book that was so serious?
Yeah, writing my book was definitely a journey. One, it was because I wrote my manuscript throughout two different pregnancies, getting adjusted, being home from prison. But on top of it, I would have to literally put myself back in my past and relive those moments in order to just be as deep and as honest and as transparent as possible. I'm just like, this is what I did. This is what I learned from it. And maybe this can help you too.
These are some really personal, close to heart topics that she's sharing with us. And I'm sure there's some people in her life who are reading this like, we didn't even know that happened to you. Because us as humans, we don't like sharing our experiences that much. We don't know who's gonna judge us. We don't know how people are gonna feel. It's difficult. So having this platform now, being on a show, writing this book, do you guys get a lot of messages asking for advice?
It's a little bit of everything, and although it does make me feel like so good, like, because that's the whole reason why I'm going to tell my story anyways, because I want to make that impact and I want to know that I'm helping other people and changing lives and things like that. But at the same time, I'm trying to like manage my life. And so when I get overwhelmed with hundreds of messages, I'm like, I have to make time. I have to let them know that they're important. I have to. And so I'm not used to being on a phone because I was in prison for 7 years and I'm only 28. So when I get like this, I'm like, oh, this is stressful. Because I'm not used to being on technology that much.
Yeah, you definitely have to catch up. You cannot be a 28-year-old out here acting like my grandmother. How you use the thing? What's this button do, baby? You can't. We need to have a crash course on the iPhone ASAP. I get it. When people come out of prison, everything is so profound to them. Any little bit of change, like, so people not buying newspapers like that no more? No, we pretty much just read TMZ. When you're in prison, the world keeps growing and changing, and you're kind of just stuck in one place doing the best that you can. So what was prison like for you?
So I've actually been to prison twice. I was incarcerated when I was 18 years old, and I had suffered from a meth addiction from the time I was 12. So I was probably the only person that you would ever meet that was beyond excited to be in prison because it meant I could be sober and it meant that I had somewhere to sleep. So unfortunately, a couple of years later, I reoffended and I ended up back incarcerated for a second time. And I'll just be honest, that second time really did something to me. I was very bitter in the beginning. I was angry because I was incarcerated on drugs as a little girl and so young. But then I realized when I had stopped looking outward, I was forced to look inward. I knew that prison was not a place I ever wanted to end up again. So I started exercising, I started meditating, I started doing all of these things that I actually really enjoyed, and I started to fall in love with myself.
Ooh, well, that was a whole ass therapy session in 60 seconds. Okay. Although I don't think that they have mirrors in prison cells, it is a great time to look into the metaphorical mirror that is, you know, within. People don't take it seriously. Some people get out and get right back in. Y'all see what the f*** goes on this show? Some people end up right back in prison. Not everybody has a happy ending. But you know, there's two people involved in this happy ending. So let's start at the beginning. Marcelino, how did you end up on this inmate website?
I originally met Brittany on a website called Meet an Inmate, and it was something that was referred to me from a friend who had been incarcerated previously. You know, when you're locked up, you're pretty much out of sight and out of mind, and it's a way for the prisoners to go ahead and try to, for the most part, they're fishing, they're trying to catch a whale and somebody who's going to support them. But then when I'm scrolling down and just seeing Brittany's picture in the profile, you know, it was very intriguing. Oh. I was drawn in. Brittany's, I guess her energy reached me through the picture.
Like, he just was like, all her pictures, he just thought she was so pretty, so beautiful. He could feel her vibes through the picture. Look, if you ever get locked up, I know one thing. Don't be all crying and bloated, swollen face in your mugshot picture, because that mugshot may be your only source of income. Have pictures ready in your phone that your people can upload to your profile, because even if it's not your mugshot, you know, you gotta have them throwback Thursdays on deck. It's hard to have normal long distance relationships when you can still FaceTime that person at 3 a.m. in the morning. So I can't imagine having a long distance relationship where you only get to talk to somebody for a little bit time of the day. You can't really check in on them. You, even when you do go get to see them, it's a lot of like restrictions on it. So how was it with your especially unique long distance relationship?
I feel like it was actually so much easier to get to know each other because we were separated. Because we weren't together physically, we only had one option if we wanted to be in a relationship and we wanted to be in a successful relationship. It was to take the time to write each other, to really be open with each other, to get to know each other. I would put in the effort to go and call. He would put in the effort to come down to see me. And, you know, his little famous line, if you eliminate the lust, what are you left with? Trust?
Eliminate the lust and build the trust.
Yeah. And that's kind of like what we did.
Okay, Marcelino, that was very youth pastor-ish of you. You know, like lust, trust with the crust. It's a must if you bust. What the f*** did he say? Whatever. You know, people always want to downplay lust. No, it's important. And I think it was important for Brittany too, because she still had some lusting going on while y'all was building that trusting, I think. Brittany, what was your relationship like in prison?
I can answer that question in two different ways, like two completely different ways. On the nurturing side, I would definitely say that there was a lot of people that looked up to me. I started a lot of little recovery groups while I was in prison, and just to try to help mentor other young women that were in prison. There's just, you know, even though prisons are rehabilitation facilities, they don't do anything to help rehabilitate the inmate. But on the flip side of that, because of, you know, the first relationship I was in with a man was quite abusive, and I do talk about that in my book. I had told myself that I was really never going to date a man again, and I had started dating women before I even went to prison. And then when I went to prison, I kind of went crazy because there was nothing in there but women. And so I had quite a few relationships while I was in prison, and we did have our cuddly time, I guess you would say.
So I think it's dope that while she was locked up, she made a group of people that were able to support each other and help each other get through that. I'm sure they probably still stay in contact to this day, because that's hard. You need somebody to lean on to get through that. So not only did she do that while she was in there, but she took that small format and basically scaled it to a larger thing by writing this book and creating awareness for something that we need to talk about. Like, we need to start more programs for addicts in prison. So shout out to Brittany for bringing awareness to this and continuing to do it after you got out. Speaking of getting out, there's pretty much two important days when you have to serve time. The day you go in and the day you get to get the f*** up out of there. So what was release day like for you guys?
What you saw on the film is actually how it happened. Mm-hmm. Brittany was, there was no previous time. She didn't go meet me and then go set up and let's do it again. It was ready, set, go. I remember she was somewhat like a deer in the headlights, you know, because all the cameras were there. there was a security guard, I guess a parole
officer. No, he was a lieutenant that came out from the parole department. I was frozen.
Deputy Duguid took it upon himself to back everybody up. And this time Brittany was still kind of like feeling like she had to be under his wing. And I was kind of like pulling her towards me like, no.
He had to just remind me like, listen, you're not in prison anymore. It's okay, you're free.
Baby.
Yes.
Should I do a donut on the way out?
You know, and it was just a really big moment for me. I don't know, that was a raw day.
It was a magical moment, that's for sure. Mm-hmm. It's not something I'm gonna soon forget. It was, I met my wife that day. It was a very special moment.
Not even giving that the finger.
Yeah.
Do it. Out the window. Out the window, please.
See, I feel like a couple times during this episode, I've had to say this. I need a man like Marcelino. That's my type of man. You know, remind me I'm free, baby. You're right, I am free. What the f***? I don't gotta listen to this man no more. Whoo! I would have danced to that car like, oh, can't do it. I'm free. It's crazy. That was the first of many lessons that you guys had to learn separately and together. Now that you know all that you know and you're at where you are in life, do you have any words for your younger selves?
I'm telling my younger self it's worth the wait. Do everything you want to for as many years as you can, and when you finally feel like you need to settle down. Don't rush it.
I guess I would tell my younger self that, like, in the end, everything is gonna be okay. I used to feel like, you know, why do I have to go through this? And now I know why, because it was for a bigger purpose and a bigger reason. So if I could tell my younger self, like, it's okay, like, you're gonna endure this for a bigger purpose, I would just wanna let myself know that, so I, you know, can hold on to that hope that it's gonna be over soon.
That's all for today. A big thanks to Marcelino and Brittany for picking up our quarantine call today. Make sure you guys like this video and subscribe to this channel because you don't want to miss out on the next episode of Lockup Unlocked Quarantine Calls Edition. You never know which one of your favorite cast members are going to pick up the call next. Until next time, I'm Cynthia Luciette. And remember, like my grandma used to always say, if you've been through some write a book about it. We'll be right back.